Hello guys, I'm Gaurav Madan and you're watching Tech in Your Shop. This is episode number 4, fun fact about number 4, Saturday, September 4th. So today we have with us one of the great entrepreneurs from India. So he's Shah Gundal, the founder of India Games, plus the founder of Roti. So we'll be knowing that in a matter of time. So today, you know, it's something amazing to have someone like him on our show. So thank you so much, sir.
Pleasure coming on our show.
So what we want to do is like can you narrate the entire entrepreneurial journey, like just two minutes.
Well, I started my career in entrepreneurship as a student in a company when I was still in school. For me, it was all about having fun. So I started with my passion of gaming, which is the economy of video games. Also, I was extremely interested in sports and games. So while India Games continued its journey, I became the India's biggest games company and finally sold India Games to Disney. So the entrepreneur in me was a and that's when I came across the idea of Roti, which was about combining wearable technology with human features, which we saw in the military. So in my case, I love things which I love and I'm passionate about. And if you convert your passion into your business, you are never working, you're always having fun. In fact, I jokingly say that all in my entire life, I have not paid for what I was doing for my job. And even now, I enjoy the entire aspect of the lifestyle. This is what I'm doing as a job. Who can that
be? So, even high school, a lot of other individuals. So, since you say that converting your hobby into something that people pay for that, so if then you know, we have to paraphrase the entire term again, like entrepreneurship, but would it be like defined as your passion? Or finding that dinosaur that problem which exists on the people. So what exactly out of these three things is on the relationship?
You see, the thing is that passion and hobbies are things which come from within. You can't say that I'm going to from tomorrow have my hobby in stamp collection or anything. It is something from within. And people basically things from within are basically tapping into their natural ability. You're not trying to be someone else. As you know, Steve Jobs was an artist in Spain, which is why the Mac and the whole Apple ecosystem was designed so beautifully, because for him, it was art. He was not creating a device or on a way back, but he was trying to create an art. This is Steve Jobs, the artist. If you look at Zuckerberg, he's extremely passionate about technology. He's coding even today on Facebook. So for him, his passion was programming. So he didn't become the CEO who's running the company. He actually bought other smart people who are actually running the company. And Zuckerberg himself is still the chief product officer and chief programmer of Facebook. So I think a lot of times people look at interviews like this and say, hey, Vishal has done this, Alok has done this. Why don't I also do this? The answer actually is not that. The answer is no answer. You can do to be good at it. This is your passion. And if you can find that, and somehow take a small element, it doesn't have to be that you need to, like Steve Jobs, you become an artist. You can be an artist. You can create this passion. I think that's the thing. It's about become a particular artist. You can be your passion. Maybe that's what it is. That's what differentiates between the winners and the winners.
Right now, I'm talking about passion. The self-motivation and the energy comes with it.
So, one thing is that in your entrepreneurial journey, you can see so many videos. If you love it, you can see it. And what if you are passionate to get those videos? And even after, you know, I'll give the example of the guys at Roti.
You know that I'm cool.
They made some 39 games. But we were passionate about it. This was any other company. Any other person was going to start
playing.
They left it. They said, no, I love it. It was 39. So the challenge might be that if you don't do this with passion and love, you will give it the 15th. the question really is the people that end up owning up to the
surrounded with a world of people who tell you why you can't do something.
you're looking for the one person who can say, I will do this. And that's the attitude which differentiates between people who are very
different. So, guys, here we have, and we have some beautiful insights from Mr. Nishan. Okay, and we want to talk something about Disney acquired your company. So, what was the feeling? I saw the speech, the uncut speech, and everybody was like really clapping around, and you were trying to tell them how much it means to you. It's not meaning that.
It's tough, right? I mean, giving your company away and giving it. But of course, Disney is a great company. So, I'm glad that India Games was acquired by Disney, and they're now taking it to the next level. I think in entrepreneurial journey, you reach a stage where you need to know when to move on. And you know, why did I take it? Because we could run for 50 years, but I didn't want to do that. I wanted to do something really exciting, which is why India Games continues to live, and it's always still a part of me.
One line to introduce something of this growth
pattern. Hockey is changing the world of
hockey.
It's disrupting the world of hockey. If you don't have hockey, you are not becoming the force. This is what you need to be the force.
Thank you so much.
Thanks.
Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe. Ding. Alright. So until next time, it's the God of Standing Off. Have a good day.